Hi Krishna, a warm good evening to all of you. I'd like to welcome for this session on dealing with stress. Someone asked me, is it the same seminar as stress management? You must have heard this buzzword, stress management. I said, no. Because my concept in regards to stress is that you have to manage only positive resources in your life. It's like time management, funds management or finance management. Stress is a kind of negative emotion which you don't have to manage, which you have to deal with. So therefore the seminar of the topic is dealing with stress. Can we give up stress completely? First of all, it's not going to be a just one-way seminar. It's a discussion wherein we can churn out something out of this useful discussion. So I expect audience also to participate into this session. So can we overcome stress completely? So stress is a part of life, right? And therefore someone has rightly said, when in ECG it shows a straight line, it means the person is dead. So similarly, there are ups and downs in the life which creates stress, and that is essential, that is symptom of life actually. A sinusoidal wave in the ECG is a symptom of life. No matter wherever you are, who you are, the stress is going to be there, whether you are a small child, whether you are a student, whether you are a corporate executive, manager of a company, whether you are a housewife, the stress is going to be there as a part of your life. Last month I had dengue and I was admitted in the hospital. So after coming from the hospital, in my recovery phase, I was just taking a stroll in the balcony of our temple, and a small child happened to meet me, and we were just in the corridor, and he said, Prabhuji, don't take stress of this. Raja, he is asking me to not take stress of this. Raja, why? Because you are in your recovery phase. I said, and then what is this? Then when I looked at there, it was a poster of today's session, dealing with stress. So it's like, you know, when you are into the water, you are supposed to get wet, right? So similarly, when we are living into this world, we are going to have a stress. And stress is also an essential part of life. Do you agree? Like in my engineering days, there used to be few students who used to, we used to call them exam freak. It means whenever the exam timetable is declared, before that they would not even study. They would not even open the book. Once the timetable is declared, then something happens from within. You know, that pressure is built up, and then because of that pressure we can study. That was their slogan. So exam freaks means what? They need some pressure on them to work, right? Some of you might be exerting some amount of pressure on your kids as well. Itne samay mein itna padhai ho jana chahiye, right? So some amount of pressure is essential for us to grow. As it is said, the dazzling effulgent diamond, it was developed under pressure. Before that, it was a charcoal, right? So a charcoal can be developed under some pressure, a proper amount of pressure, into a diamond, dazzling diamond. Now that amount of pressure is very important. Similarly, in our life also, we need pressure. Under that, we can grow. But beyond the threshold limit of that pressure, beyond the tolerance limit of the pressure, then what happens? We might break down. And therefore, it is very essential. So the positive aspect of stress, and there is a negative aspect of stress. Positive aspect of stress is the amount of pressure which is essential, required for us to grow through, like the charcoal has to go through to become a diamond. So similarly, is the positive pressure and the positive stress. And the negative stress is what which we are going to discuss today, how to deal with it. Do you agree with me? Yes. So our course journey will be something like this. We'll see the problem definition, the cause analysis, conventional solutions which people offer, paradigm shift, because we have gathered to hear this talk in the temple. So obviously there is going to be a different perspective towards the solution. Lifestyle management tips, based on scriptures. So when we talk about stress, it's the number one disease of the modern world today. World Health Organization, they have published a report wherein it said the greatest disease of this 21st century is not AIDS, not cancer, it's mental stress. You take it as stress, you take it as anxiety, you take it as depression, you take it as frustration. They're all members of the same family, dealing with mind. The number one disease, it's all pervasive. Everyone has it. As I told, whether you are a small child, whether you are CEO of a company, everyone has some amount of negative stress in their life. Do you agree? And especially while dealing with engineering students, we have a hostel, we run ISKCON run hostel, wherein we guide students in their career as well as studies as well as spiritual life. They have a big problem, what we can say, the job crisis. Most of the engineers today, they are going through this job crisis. एक बार एक इंजीनियर कॉलेज का पास आउट, वो एक कैसे साधु महाराज के पास जाता है, पूछता है महाराज जॉब नहीं मिल रहा है. बाबा पूछते हैं कौन सी ब्रांच है तुम्हारी, वो कहता है कंप्यूटर. साधु कहते हैं कि क्षमा करना बेटा, मेरी कंप्यूटर थी. सम डिफरेंट ब्रांच, आई एम फ्रॉम अ डिफरेंट ब्रांच, ही हैज बिकम साधु. बाय दैट वे आई एम नॉट दैट काइंड ऑफ साधु. ऑल परवेजी, एवरीवन हैज इट. It's the hidden enemy which you can't locate. Where is the stress situated? Is there any barometer? Obviously, there are some stress tests which doctors do conduct, but that is just related to some heart cardiac disease. But there is no proper measure how much stress do you have. And specifically, is it positive or is it going into the negative zone? There is no measure. It's hidden. One time a person went to a psychologist for counseling. He was going through some depression phase in his life. So went to a doctor, was consulting with the psychologist. We know what kind of solutions they offer. Sometimes they are very wonderful. So this psychologist said, in our city, there is a comedian. He makes laughter shows. You please go and attend his sessions. The more you laugh, all your depression will go away. Kindly go and visit, that's all. This person said, my dear doctor, I am that comedian. I make people laugh, but I am going through this depression phase in my life. It's the hidden enemy. No matter what kind of plastic smile or real smile you have on your face, inside what is going on, we can't judge. So it's a hidden enemy, uniquely different from other diseases. As I told you, other diseases, if there is ever, there is a test which you can do, there is a dengue test, there is malaria test, so different tests can be conducted. But here, we can't do any kind of such test, therefore it's unique. Underlying factor for many variety of physical and mental illnesses is the underlying cause. It's also the one of the cause of heart attacks. It's also one of the cause, some people say, it's also the cause of cancer as well, because in the previous ages the prominent diseases were diarrhea, pneumonia, typhoid, but in this age the diseases are heart attack, cancer, diabetes, blood pressure. And WHO has reported that by the year 2025, 7 out of 10 deaths because of this stress related issue. Going ahead, what is this stress? We'll look more into it. It's a state of the mind which distorts comfortable way of living. Some of the simple definitions I have gathered. A state of mind which distorts the comfortable way of living. Now, therefore, it's called ease and disease. It means it removes the ease from your life, therefore it's called as disease. Distress due to any kind of burden, pressure or hardship. When there is pressure, there is hardship involved, it creates stress. Any condition that gives rise to worry, tension and frustration. Any situation that gives rise to these three, that is called as stressful condition. How does stress arise? From a transaction between an individual and the environment, when the individual perceives the stimuli as either damaging or threatening or challenging. When an individual faces a situation wherein the stimuli means he perceives it as it might be heartening to me, this might break my relationship. So when the situation is like that, that kind of pressure creates stress in the mind of the people. Like in the battlefield of Kurukshetra Bhagavad Gita, at the start of the war itself, Arjuna was into fully stressful condition. Whether I should fight this or I should not fight this battle. Why? Because my relatives are standing in front of me, the dilemma. So he was perceiving this situation and the environment as not challenging. It was not a challenge for him. He had already defeated many of them, opponent, enemies. But he was considering it as damaging and threatening. Why damaging? Because many of the people will die. I may incur sinful reaction of killing these people. That was his doubt. And that dilemma put Arjuna into a stress. And the whole Bhagavad Gita, then it's like a stress management, or you can say dealing with stress manual. And at the end, he became confident and he fought the war, not only fought the war, but won the battle. So, this is how a stress arises. Human function curve, when it's plotted, arousal or stress against performance, we need, as we discussed, we need some kind of stress to function. So, as this little stress increases, our performance also goes high, till the point of E is called as exhaustion, and the intended performance is shown by the dotted line. It should go up. But when the stress level increases more, the actual performance declines. And you see there, the I is the point of ill health. We become ill under a lot of pressure. And then at point B, there is breakdown. And you need a solid big break out of your work. So this is human function curve. That's why we need to deal. So the topic of discussion today is beyond point E. As we discussed at the start of the session, the positive pressure is up to point E, and beyond point E is a negative pressure, is a negative stress which we have to deal with. And therefore, stress arises when the demands are greater than the resources. Demands greater than resources. Just to give an example, this all they might have put up, let us say 7500 chairs. And if 250 people come in, then what will happen? Demands are greater than resources. Then there will be a stress. Then all the organizers will be in panic. What to do now? Let us ask the audience to come forward, and something they'll do. So this stress is created when the demands are greater than resources. And the best example of this is too much to do in life, but too little time to accomplish things. Now I am going to put forth some of the scenarios here. You can just tell me whether you experience some of these emotions in your life or not. The very first is, I need more time. How many of you have experienced this emotion? Thoda samay jyada chahiye tha. 24 ghanta kyun bana hai? Itna kuch karne ke liye mere paas, I have to do this, do that, right? I need little more time and I will be happy and peaceful. My life is in stress because I have less time. So sometimes this is the scenario. Next is, I want to enjoy my life more. I am always running around. I never have time for myself. This also sometimes we experience this. This just isn't life. I am stressed out. Give me a break. I have no balance between my personal life and my work life. My professional life and my personal life, they are not in sync. They are out of balance, and therefore I am in stress. Do we experience such kinds of scenarios in our life? Yes, truly. Kindly go through this statement. We are not stressed because we have no time, but rather we have no time because we are stressed. Are you getting it? We are not stressed because we have no time. Samay ki kami hai, isliye stress ki pareshani nahi hai. Why? We have no time because we are stressed. So stress actually consumes a lot of time. It's not that we lack time. It's the thing that a lot of time is consumed by worries, anxieties, and stress in our life. What is the cause of this stress? What do you think? What are the causes of this stress? Expectations, yeah, wonderful. We keep expectations from others. This should be a perfect person, but no one is perfect. Too much? Too much ambition or ambitious. Do this, do this. Dil mange? More. So that is also a cause of stress. Very good. What else? Overburden. Yeah. The kind of over pressure. I have capacity to eat only 3 gulab jam, but my plate is full of 30. What to do now? So overburden, yeah. Responsibilities, yes, responsibilities give rise to stress to some extent. But sometimes it's the positive stress as well. Too much ego, too much keeping your ego. Someone hurts your ego, and then how can this person say this to me? And then you go into a panic, stressful zone. So these are some of the causes. When things or people does not behave the way we expect, as our dear friend, he said, expectations. Most of you might be using smartphones in your life. So if I have a phone, Android phone, you are into a remote place wherein there is no network or no range for the internet, and urgently you have to do some task. You keep doing you, and there is no one with you. When the things don't function as per our expectations, the stress level goes up, right? And things, these are not only about things, but also about people. When people don't behave as per our expectations, then also there is stress. Do you agree? So the stress level is there when people don't behave. Ek bar ek mahila doctor ke paas jati hai, unke ek samasya thi. Doctor bolte, madam aapka headache kaise hai? Madam bolte, wo abhi gaon se bahar gaye hue. So the point is that anyone can be the cause of our stress. When people don't behave as per our expectations, there is a lot of stress. Stress is caused because of the gap between expectation and reality. You expect something very high, but reality is something different. And when you see that, a lot of stress. Ek bar ek ladki pandit ji ke paas jati aur pandit ji ko puchti, pandit ji, aise ladke ko kya kehte hain jo dikhne mein handsome hai, khoobsurat hai, bahut paisa kamane wala hai, ameer khandan ka hai, educated hai, meri care bhi karega, ghar walon ki care bhi karega, ghar ka sab kaam bhi karega. ऐसे लड़के को क्या कहते हैं? पंडित जी ने कहा, ऐसे लड़के को मन का वहम कहते हैं. टू हाई एक्सपेक्टेशंस, बट द रियलिटी इज समथिंग डिफरेंट. सो व्हेन दिस हैपेंस, दिस आल्सो कॉजेस स्ट्रेस. नेगेटिव इमोशंस लाइक फियर, एनवी, ईगो, दिस आल्सो आर सम ऑफ द कॉजेस ऑफ स्ट्रेस. How do we tackle this stress then? So let us see, what are these conventional solutions which people talk about? Different people resort to different ways to tackle stress. What are the conventional ways people deal, people tackle stress with? Meditation, yes, meditation to some extent people do that. Problem? Solutions. Looking for the solutions into this problem, actually, case to case. Patience, tolerance. Take rest, so jao. Relax. So jata hu, sab main samasya bhul jata hu. many of the people, pathetic situation today is that they resort to all this. Do you agree? पीने वाले को एक बार पूछा आप क्यों पीते हैं, बोलते हैं गम भुलाने के लिए पीता हूँ. गम का अर्थ क्या है? स्ट्रेस ही ना. सो टू फॉरगेट स्ट्रेस, एज समवन सेड स्लीप. सो दिस विल हेल्प यू इन स्लीपिंग, पुट यू इन टू परमानेंट स्लीप मे बी. सो दिस ट्रैंक्विलाइजर्स, एंटरटेनमेंट, स्मोकिंग, ड्रिंकिंग. रिसेंटली आई कंडक्टेड अ प्रोग्राम फॉर एडिक्ट्स इन अ डी एडिक्शन सेंटर. यंगेस्ट पर्सन देयर वॉज 14-year-old boy, severe drug addict from Mumbai. Day before yesterday only I conducted. So this is the situation that people, to overcome that stress in their life, they succumb to such kinds of negative shelters. So we need shelter obviously, but when we seek that shelter in positive things, then that can be a real solution to the problem. So when you succumb to these things, does it really help? Does it really help? Rather, one gets addicted to bad habits and it implicates your life and further complicates your situation, right? So therefore, these are not the solution. And so therefore, tackling stress, we need a paradigm shift. You know paradigm shift? Paradigm shift means looking from a totally different perspective altogether. So to begin with, a small exercise for all of you. You have to join these 9 dots with 4 lines without lifting the pen. Is it possible? Possible? You can do it? Very good. So I'll show you 4 lines. Many times people try. You also have, you have a paper and pen, you can try that. You get totally absorbed into the 9 dots, but solution is not that simple. One time I was conducting a seminar in engineering college and I gave to the same puzzle to the students over there. One boy stood up and said, "Ek line extra de do keval, bas main kar dunga turant." Divert, differently thinking. So here, I'll give you the solution. We are spending much time into it. So this is the first line. Here you go, second line, the third line, and the fourth line. So if you keenly observe the first line, did you notice something? It has to go out of the box of those 9 dots and then again come back to the box. This is called as out of the box thinking, and this is also called as the paradigm shift. So the paradigm shift is very important because it's not the load that breaks you down, it's the way you carry it. It's not the load, right? It's how you carry. So therefore, these situations are going to be there in our life till we die. We have to live, we have to accept. How we carry those situations in our life, how we respond to those situations in our life positively, with these, some of the tools which I am going to share today, that will define whether we will be able to carry that load, whether that load breaks us down or whether that load uplifts up. So therefore, some of the time, or we can say these lifestyle management tips I am going to share with you today, these are managing priorities and living a balanced life, a process-oriented approach, applying this CA formula, living one's own life, meditation and breathing exercises. To begin with, managing priorities and living a balanced life. Like we said, the stress is generated because demands are greater than the supply or the resources. We have less amount of time and we have many things to do. And everyone has gone through this situation, right? Time is less, things are more. I have to do this, read newspaper, do yoga, do this, do that. A number of things we have to do. So there is somewhere imbalance. So how do we balance our life? And the key to balance is prioritization. Going ahead, human needs are classified into four categories, and these categories are titled as four L's of life. All our needs can be categorized into these four L's. The first one is need to live, need to learn, need to love, and need to leave a legacy behind. Need to live, the first one, is our physical need. For living, what we need to eat, we need to take proper rest, we need to do exercise to remain healthy, fit and fine. So this is our physical need, a need to live. Next is need to learn, that is our mental need, to learn something new, to acquire new set of skills, to learn a new language. So that is our mental need. Next is need to love, that is our social need. We need to have friends, we need to have someone with whom we can share our problems with, we can share our happiness, we can share our distress with them. That is our social need, that is need to love. And then the last is need to leave a legacy behind, that is our spiritual need, living with a higher purpose in our life. So any kind of need you identify in your life, this is my need, that will go into any one of the categories of these four L's. So balancing means what? Balancing doesn't mean that you sacrifice one at the cost of the other. Balancing means everyone should be given equal weightage based on the priority of that particular item. For some time we might do, like there is some big pressure, like Diwali is coming and then housewives have to cook a lot, make some items, these many items. For some time, students are there. I have seen many of the students in the hostel, they spend sleepless nights before the exam and during the exams. But that particular time is okay, but that cannot be a routine for the entire life. Do you agree? So we need a proper balance. We need a proper sleep in our life to remain fit and fine. Similarly, we need to eat properly in our life. So all these things needs to be taken care of. That is called as balance of our life. A small exercise for all of you. What one thing could you do in your life if you did on a regular basis would make a tremendous difference in your life? What one thing could you do in your life? Now what you have to do, maybe you can close your eyes for 15 seconds and just ponder on that one thing which you want to do in your life, and if done on a regular basis, it would create a tremendous impact on your life. Your time starts now. 15 seconds. Close your eyes. Ponder on that one important thing in your life which you want to plan, which you are not able to give justice to. But if done on a regular basis, it would certainly create an impact in your life, and your life will be totally different if you do that. Now, my dear friends, open. Your time is up. Now, because it's a very important thing in your life, immediately it would have flashed in front of your eyes, closed eyes. Right? So keep that thing with you. I'm not going to ask it. Keep it at the back of the mind. We will go ahead in our discussion. So therefore, there is a matrix called as time management matrix. You must have heard this many times in the time management seminars as well. So there are four quadrants based on importance and the urgency of the event or the thing which you want to do. The important and urgent things fit into quadrant 1. Important but which are not urgent, they go into quadrant 2. Urgent and not important, they go into quadrant 3. The things which are neither urgent nor important go into quadrant 4. Now, what are these things? I'll give an example. You come in the evening from the office and on the door you find a notice, a corporation notice to vacate your home. Ghar chhodke chale jao. like corporation has issued some of the notices to some of the temples. You might have heard about in the newspapers, it was a big issue in Nasik, Nagpur and Mumbai, Aurangabad as well, that you vacate within 15 days, no further proceedings, vacate, or else we will come and demolish. So some same notice is there, maybe because of n number of reasons, the corporation has put up a notice on your door, you please vacate within 24 hours, no further questions asked. This needs to be taken care of urgently because it's an important issue, right? It's both important, it's both urgent for your life. But at the same time, when you look at the clock, you look at the watch in your hand, you notice that it's time for me to go to yoga to reduce my weight. Now, do you think it's important? Yes, it's important, but it's not urgent. Notice ko baad mein dekhte pehle thoda yoga karke aate, reduce some exercise, reduce some weight. You will not go for that, right? At the same time, your phone rings and a friend calls for a dinner. Because urgency is created, phone is ringing. Many of the times it happens, you know, the phone creates a sense of urgency. You might be having a important discussion with someone in front of you and the phone rings, you give priority to the phone. Namaste, idea company se baat kar rahe hai. And then faltu mein phone uthaya, achcha khasa discussion chal raha tha. So it creates an urgency syndrome, but it is at that particular point of time, it is not important. And also you realize now the time is passing. You realize that it's my favorite TV serial is about to start now. You enter into the home. Will you sit on the sofa and watch the television peacefully? No. Because at that particular point of time, it is neither important, it is nor urgent. So is this matrix clear to you? Urgent, important? So it's very essential to understand time management. Now, this is the overview of this, urgent and important, important but not urgent, urgent and not important, not urgent. So these are the four matrices. How do we deal? How do we deal with these situations in our life? First quadrant is called as quadrant of action. You have to immediately take some action for the notice given by the corporation. Quadrant of action. Second is quadrant of quality. Things are important in life, but they are not urgent. And therefore, we might postpone these things, and we have a tendency to postpone those things as well. Urgent but not important, friend calling for, it's called as quadrant of deception. And last, it's called as quadrant of waste. So these are the titles of these four quadrants. How do we deal? Quadrant of action, immediately do it. Quadrant of quality, plan for it. Quadrant of deception, negotiate with it. I'll come sometime later for the dinner. And quadrant of waste, trash it. Because it's going to waste your time. Now, my dear ladies and gentlemen, you have that one thing in your mind which I had asked you to keep at the back of the mind. Now bring it into the front of your mind. The thing which you have assumed in your mind is certainly important, and if done on a regular basis, it would have a tremendous impact on your life. That one thing lies in the second quadrant of this time management matrix. How many of you say this is true? Kaise pehchan liya? Jadugar hai kya? Am I a magician? For you, the important thing might be to do yoga on a regular basis. I will be like healthy, fit and fine. For some of you, the important thing could be me to start writing so that I could publish a book later. For some of you, it might be to develop a relationship with someone, a good relation, so that my life will be peaceful. But most of the these things in our life are important to us, we know that. But because we don't have a plan of action for this, we keep postponing. Aaj yoga nahi kiya to kuch farak padne wala hai. Even if I don't do yoga, something is going to happen. So we keep postponing those things and we become a procrastinator in our life. And that's how this creates an imbalance in our life, which is the number one cause of stress. Any question till this point of time? Should we proceed? The second lifestyle management tip is process orientation versus product orientation. Might be a new concept for some of you. While living in this world, we have become very much product oriented. Product in the sense, it's not market ka product. Product here is end result. Is what? End result. Kisi ka job lag gaya, we immediately, we don't ask how is your boss, how is your job. We immediately ask for salary kitna aayega, end result. A student is there, we don't ask how are your studies going on, how do you love this subject. We immediately ask, marks kitna mila, bata. So we have become product oriented, end result. Slideshow is running here, last slide kya aane wala hai? What is going to be the last slide? So mind goes into the end. One time I was traveling in a train to Vrindavan. My last station was Mathura. I boarded from Nasik and along with me a family also boarded. And we became friend during travel. So there was a small boy, maybe 7-8 years old, and he was very becoming panicky. Mathura, kab aayega. And when the train would stop, he would ask, Mathura aa gaya kya? He would just peek from the window, Mathura aa gaya kya? So he was constantly becoming panic for the end result of going to Mathura. He made his entire journey miserable. And for me, given an opportunity of a long travel, I am the happiest person. Why? Because I have so many unread emails, so many unread WhatsApp notifications, which create a symptom of urgency, but they are not. I don't say they are not important, but they have a time to do. We should definitely have a plan for that as well. I can write articles. I'm an avid reader. I read books. So that I fill my entire travel time with all these things and traveling becomes fun. So I was totally enjoying the journey, but this boy, he was frustrated with the journey. Why? What was the difference? Because the boy was product oriented, end result kab aane wala hai, and because I was process oriented, I was enjoying the journey, I was looking out, now we are going through this state, acha, what does this state look like, are there rains here, is there greenery here, so I was just looking through the train and I was happy and the boy was stressful, the stress was there. Because he was constantly focusing on the end result. One time, a person went to Japan. And there, he went into a piano making industry. Japan is also a very good manufacturer of pianos. So he went into a company. And at the end of the piano, there is a cast iron box, small cast iron box, plate is there, small cast iron plate, a finished plate is kept and the strings are strung over there. So this person who went to Japan, he went to a supervisor and asked the question, how many number of plates do you make every day? How many number of plates do you make every day? And this person whose job was to just file a particular number of plates, make it super fine and stick it over there at the proper place, and then it will go to the next destination. When this question was asked, how many number of plates you make every day, the reply this person, the worker gave, was amazing. He said, the goal of my being here is not to make number of acceptable plates, but make perfect plates. I just make perfect plates, and that is my goal. I doesn't count how many number of plates I make. This person was stunned, he was taken aback. How can you say like this? I just make few perfect plates. Don't you have a supervisor here to supervise you? And this worker said, it's my job. Why I need someone to supervise my job? It's my job. Getting the point? When I am doing my job, why I need someone else to supervise me while doing my job? It's my job. Bharat mein aisa hota.
One has to maintain quality as well.
So why we need a supervisor? So this person was stunned, and because of this mentality, they are not product oriented. End result ke sanal kuch nahi. They are process oriented. We are going to make like this, and then end result ultimately comes good. And because of that, this attitude, Japan ranked number one, and they could beat America in automobiles and electronic gadgets because of just this process orientation approach. I still remember, immediately after being elected as a Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi ji, he kept a session for students. The session was only for students on a teacher's day, 5th of September, teacher's day, and he had kept an open discussion with all the students. A small girl, she asked a question to Modi ji. She asked this question, क्या आपने कभी पंतप्रधान बनने का सपना देखा था? He gave a stunning reply, which I will never forget. उन्होंने reply दिया, देखो बेटा, जिंदगी में कुछ बनने के सपने मत देखो, कुछ करने के सपने देखो. कुछ करने के सपने देखो, कुछ बनने के सपने मत देखो. And many times this happens with us. हम हमेशा कुछ बनने के सपने देखते हैं. I will become this, I will become that, I want to become. करने के सपने देखो, आई विल टेक दिस मेनी एफर्ट्स, और करते करते कुछ बन गए तो बहुत अच्छी बात है. करते करते कुछ बन गए तो बहुत अच्छी बात है. अदरवाइज वी हैव दिस ड्रीम एंड देन द ड्रीम इज नॉट फुलफिल, यू बिकम फ्रस्ट्रेटेड. डू एग्री विद दिस? सो वी बिकम मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इन आवर लाइफ प्रोडक्ट ओरिएंटेड, एंड रिजल्ट ओरिएंटेड, एंड वी फॉरगेट द प्रोसेस विच लीड्स टू दैट प्रोडक्ट. Just to give an example, hota nahi hai. Many people don't do. Yeah, it's a different issue altogether. It's a different issue altogether. I just give an example for us to understand. What is this approach of product orientation and process orientation? The best example of this is Jatayu. Few days ago, we went on a tour with a group of families to Taked, which is just 50-60 kilometers from Nasik. Jatayu, you know, Jatayu fought the battle with Ravana in the mission of protecting Sita. Jatayu knew that I am going to lose this battle. Imagine fighting a losing battle. He was very old. No one has asked him to fight the battle, but still he fought the battle. He was into the process. If he would have thought about the product, the end result, I am going to lose, then he would have thought, why should I fight? So similarly in our life as well, I will just give a simple example. How many of you have done trekking? Trekking to any kind of fort or thoda parvat pe chadhai kiya hua hai? Kahi to upar chadhe hai kahi to. Right, we have done trekking. So during trekking, maybe on a fort, maybe on like any kind of shikhar, when you do trekking, Let us say Brahmagiri is there in near Nasik, right? Brahmagiri, when we go to Brahmagiri, we go up while trekking. How much time does it take to climb up? Roughly 1.5 to 2 hours, right? And coming down, 1 hour, an hour. How much time do we spend on the top? Hardly half an hour, yes. We spend hardly half an hour on the top. Maximum amount of time we are spending on climbing and coming down. Acha. While climbing up, we enjoy the trek, right? Imagine, if someone offers a help to you, आप हमारे हेलीकॉप्टर में बैठ जाइए, आपको ऊपर लेके जाएंगे, आपको 10 मिनट बिताना ऊपर, ठीक है, 10 मिनट बिताओ, आपको नीचे लेके आएंगे. विल यू एंजॉय दैट? यू विल नॉट एंजॉय, बिकॉज द रियल एंजॉयमेंट एक्चुअली इज ड्यूरिंग द क्लाइंबिंग ऑफ दैट माउंटन, दैट इज प्रोसेस ओरिएंटेशन. सो द रियल हैप्पीनेस, द रियल एंजॉयमेंट लाइज नॉट इन द प्रोडक्ट बट इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ अकम्प्लिशिंग द प्रोडक्ट. एंड देयरफॉर इट सेड real happiness comes not in the destination but in the journey towards the destination. Many times we preoccupy our lives with a thought about the product, with the thought about the destiny, so much preoccupied that we forget the journey, we forget the process, and the process becomes burden. Do you agree? Bachchon ke liye kabhi bhi hum log batate hai ki itna aapko marks lana hai, padhai unke liye burden ho jayega. Many times I deal with students, n number of students. पढ़ाई में मन नहीं लगता, सबका यही प्रश्न है, हमारा मन नहीं लग रहा पढ़ाई में. We get bored during studies. Job करते हैं हमको bore हो जाता है, हमको break चाहिए. We need weekends so that we can enjoy and do something different. It means the job is not enjoyable because we have just given a status of the end result we want. The salary is enjoyable, rest all the things are not then. So when we have this attitude of product orientation towards anything, then the process becomes a burden and that generates a lot of stress in our life. So if we want to deal with the stress, then we need to have this paradigm shift from product orientation to the process orientation. Start loving the process. Start loving the process. Start loving the journey. And not worry about the destination. So, what is the outcome of just becoming a product oriented? Vidyarthi ko keval marks se concern hai. Just I want good marks, that's all. No matter by what way, by what means I am getting, and he may succumb to these bad habits of cheating. Why people cheat? Tell me. Why students cheat during the exams? They are insecure. Okay. The root cause is they are product oriented. Marks chahiye. Ye na ke na prakar hai na, itne marks aane chahiye. Finish. Phir wo kaise bhi aaye. Some of my colleagues and myself, we took admission into a Sanskrit academy. It was a distance learning academy, Sanskrit Bharati. They do provide some distance learning courses and certification for that. So, three of us participated into this exam. They provided us the booklet. They declared the exam date. On that particular date, you have to write the answer sheet and submit in a proper school they had announced. So two of us, my friend and myself, we studied for 6 months. It was a course of 6 months. We studied for 6 months. We wrote an exam. It was like you have to write at your home only. Ghar pe baith ke liye, distance learning. And then submit the paper. So just before submitting the paper, one of the third fellow, he said, just give me your paper. He xeroxed it. And then he said, you go and submit your paper. I submitted paper in the morning at 11 o'clock. He submitted the same paper. He just took a xerox, just copied down, submitted the paper at 5 o'clock. 1 month after the exam, the results were declared. Three of us got A grade in that particular exam. Now, I got A. The friend along with me who also appeared for the exam, he got A. The third person who had just copied, he also got A. The product remains the same. End result is same, right? Everyone got grade A. But did the third person learn something? Knowledge kuch mila usko? He didn't learn anything. So he, there was, means even if by getting A grade, he had got the product, but he had not got the knowledge of the subject. He has not got the, no command of the subject. He didn't get, he didn't learn anything. Just to show a certificate that I have got this certificate now, that's all. So the attitude of product orientation is that it makes you go for shortcuts in your life, because the goal is product and not the process. And because of that, the process becomes a burden. Whenever we have many people here, we study these we learn these musical instruments, you know. So the moment we enter into the practice of this musical instrument, it takes lot of patience to learn a new musical instrument. And immediately on day one itself, the boy who is starting learning this musical instrument, he is thinking, he is looking to a perfect person, when the day will come I will be able to play like this person. When the day will come I will be able to play like this person. Are you practice karna achche se? तू काय को प्रोडक्ट की चिंता करते, तू प्रैक्टिस करेगा अच्छे से तो तू एक दिन बजा लेगा वैसे. एंड देयरफॉर इट सेड देयर इज नो शॉर्टकट टू सक्सेस. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हैव प्लेड वीडियो गेम्स इन योर लाइफ? चिंता करने की आवश्यकता नहीं है, या बच्चों के साथ देखा होगा वीडियो गेम्स. नाउ व्हेन देयर इज अ वीडियो गेम, यू माइट हैव सीन ऑन द टॉप राइट कॉर्नर ऑफ द स्क्रीन अ स्कोर इज डिस्प्लेड, right? Scoreboard. I remember we used to have, when we were kids, we used to play also a small game, and a vehicle wala game. Usme keval vehicles hi the. A vehicle is going and then obstructions you have to just bypass and then cross, and the speed would increase in the next level, and there would be a score displayed on the top right corner of the screen. But how many of you are even aware of the score while playing? We are least bothered about the score, right? When the game ends, then the scoreboard, it comes for us. Itna score ho gaya mera, right? So we are least bothered about the score. We are just enjoying the game, right? And therefore, dear friends, the game is enjoyable, because we are not looking for the end result, because we are not looking for the product. We are just enjoying the process. Same thing can happen, and we can enjoy any kind of process, whether it's cooking, whether it's sweeping, whether it's doing a job, whether it's studying. For students, when you start loving the thing which you are pursuing, when you start loving the practice, then what happens? Product takes a secondary role and process takes a primary role in your life, and the stress level goes down. Do you agree? To some extent, yes. Going ahead, the CA formula. I am not asking you to become CAs, chartered accountants. What does the C and A stands for? C stands for change the changeable. A stands for accept the unchangeable. There are two kinds of things in our life. They might be people, they might be things, they might be situations which we go through in life. So let us see the first one, change the changeable. Jo badal sakte hai use badalne ka prayas karo ya use badlo. Based on this, there are two types of managers. One is called as circumstantial manager, the second is called as substantial manager. A circumstantial manager always blames the circumstances and the situations around. ये परिस्थिति अच्छी नहीं है, ये मशीन अच्छा नहीं, इसलिए मेरा प्रोडक्टिविटी कम है, ये लोग अच्छा काम नहीं करते, इसलिए कुछ हो नहीं रहा है. Blames the situations and the surroundings and the circumstances. That is called as circumstantial manager. Another one is called as substantial manager. He is the man of substance. He looks within and he don't blame the situations and the circumstances around, and therefore circumstantial manager, his attitude is paristhiti badlo, and a substantial manager's thought is manasthiti badlo. If you can't change the paristhiti, you can obviously change the manasthiti, which is in our hand. One time, a manager of a company, he was coming from office. During the office work, there was some mistake from his hand, and boss has scolded him left and right, black and blue or whatever you say. A horrible day, was leaving the office, left the office. As soon as he left the office, he noticed that someone has stolen his wallet, a pickpocketer stolen. The pocket is no more there with him. Then, with his vehicle, he comes home. As soon as he was getting down from his vehicle, he slips on the ground because of banana peels which were there near the place where he parked his car. So he slept down and he fell badly. The boss has scolded him. The wallet has been stolen and fell down because of carelessness of someone. Banana chilka wahan pe dala tar wahin pe gaadi lagai. Enters into the home. Silence. Total silence. खाने के समय हो जाता है, वाइफ खाना बना के दाल राइस सब्जी चपाती का प्लेट सामने रखा हुआ है. यू वांट टू लीव, यू कैन. सो प्लेट, हाँ, सो द, थैंक यू. सो द प्लेट इज देयर केप्ट इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम. दाल का कटोरा लेते हैं, एक घूंट दाल पिया, दाल में नमक नहीं है. दाल में नमक बिल्कुल नहीं है. बॉस ने स्कोल्ड किया है, डाटा है, वॉलेट चोरी हो गया है, फिसल के गिरे हुए हैं. पूरा फ्रस्ट्रेशन निकाल सकते हैं वाइफ के ऊपर, निकालने के लिए निकाल सकते हैं. तेरे को माँ ने ऐसा ही सिखाया है क्या, कभी दाल बनाया नहीं जीवन में. ही चोज द सेकंड ऑप्शन. क्या किया उन्होंने, भगवान इधर आओ, उसको बिठाया बगल में. हमारे शादी के लिए हो गए, लेकिन मैंने अपने हाथ से तुम्हें कभी खिलाया नहीं है आज तक. चलो आज मैं तुम्हें खिलाता हूँ. एक चम्मच लिया, दाल लिया और पिलाई उसको. अरे नमक डालना भूल गई. कुछ बात नहीं, हो सकता है, जाओ जाके गर्म करके लाओ, नमक डाल के आ जाओ. सिचुएशन जब परिस्थिति नहीं बदल कर सकते, what you have to change? You can obviously change your manasthiti, the things which are in your control. Many times we also go through these situations, right? In our life, kahan ka gussa kahan pe utar dete hai, kahan ka jhagda hua kahan pe nikal dete hai. Kabhi kabhi hum we become victimized by such types of situations. So obviously there are situations, people, things which are beyond our control, but there are going to be things which are in our control. And therefore it's said there are two types of circles. One is called a circle of influence, another is called a circle of concern. Circle of influence means you can do something about it. Kuch kar sakte hai, within your control. October heat is there, temperature is rising. Okay, let me turn on the fan. Within my control, I can do something about it. Do it. Circle of influence. Circle of concern. Trump has made some policies. Let me check out what are the recent policies for Indians in America. Can you do something about it? Circle of concern. So many a times what happens, we spend lot of time discussing situations, peoples and surroundings which are in the circle of concern. The more we focus our life on the circle of concern, then circle of concern increases and it reduces the circle of influence. Jitna control hai na wo bhi chala jata hai. On the contrary, the more we focus on the circle of influence, kitna main kar sakta hu utna main karunga, the circle of influence will increase and it will enter into the concern zone, and a point will come that you will be able to influence at a higher level as well. So therefore, we need to spend a lot of time on circle of influence, change the things which you can, but there are going to be some things which you cannot, right? Here we have to accept the things which are unchangeable. Ghar pe rehte aap log television dekhte, kuch serial bore ho gaya, aap challenge change kar denge, right? Change the changeable. Yahan pe aa gaye pravachan ke liye, bore ho raha hai, kuch kar sakte hai, channel change. You can't accept the unchangeable. Accept the unchangeable. Something happens against our will. Hamari ichcha ke viruddha kuch hota hai. There are two kinds of responses. We might not accept, we might accept. Non-acceptance of something happening against will leads to anger. When we accept, it leads to tolerance. Uncertainties in life, something uncertain. Non-acceptance leads to fear, acceptance leads to adventure. Uncertainties, you know, adventurous people, they like uncertainties. The next is, someone has more than me. My goodness. Non-acceptance leads to envy and jealousy, but acceptance leads to inspiration. I take an inspiration from this person. Someone hurts me. Non-acceptance leads to hatred of that person. Acceptance leads to forgiveness. Based on all these slides, I have come to a life equation. In conclusion, we can say that this is the life equation. Non-acceptance of situations, people, things around you leads to negative emotions, but on the contrary, acceptance of them as they are leads to positive emotions in your life. What is this famous picture about? You all know. 9/11 WTC attack. One company wanted to do a research. What was this research? All those people who survived, not in the building, those who were absent on that particular day only. They interviewed all those people who were on leave on that particular day. They were all gathered together and they were interviewed. आपका कारण क्या था छुट्टी का? And if that interview, that page is there available, interview report, entire report is available. I can share that report if you want. A lady replied that it was the first day of my school, I had to go and attend to him. Someone replied that we were having breakfast and the plate spilled on my dress, and because of that changing of the dress, it took a lot of time and I was unable to reach office on time. Someone said, my alarm didn't ring only. I couldn't get up properly on time, and that's why I was absent on that particular day at that particular time. Someone said, I missed my bus. Someone said, my car didn't start. And amazingly, one person said, on that particular day, I wore new shoes. नए जूते पहने थे, and there was a blister on his foot, and to diagnose and treat that blister, he had to go to a first aid center over there on the road, and a lot of time went there, and he was unable to attend his duties. चप्पल ने काटा था उसको, hospital first aid center गया वहाँ पे. All these situations, imagine these situations when we look into. Frustrating situations, छोटी छोटी घटनाएं हैं लेकिन हमें काम पे जाने के लिए रोक रही है, right? All those, but when they might have missed their day, particular day in the office, but they have saved their lives. And now they thank those situations in their life. So many times we also go through many negative, small negative incidences and situations. We might miss a bus, we might miss a taxiway, our car might not start, some urgent call may come up. We don't have to take all these small situations in a negative way. There might be something positive happening in our life in the future. And therefore it said the secret of any relationship depends on this one formula. That formula is, the survival of any relationship depends on accepting people as they are and not how you want them to be. मेरे हिसाब से उस व्यक्ति ने ऐसा ही होना चाहिए, ऐसा होगा नहीं, नहीं होता है. And therefore there are relationship clashes, there are relationship problems and many issues, they keep coming up just because people are not ready to accept other people as they are. And therefore there is a very nice slide, you may also might have seen this somewhere. Do you have problems in life? Yes or no? Let us say, start with no. If you don't have any problem with life, then why you worry? Because there are no problems in life, you don't have to worry. Okay, you have problems in life? Yes? Yes? Can you do something about your problems in life? If you can't do anything about your life, then why worry? You can't do anything. And if you can do something about your life, then also why worry? Because you can do something about your life. So in any case, the conclusion comes, why worry? Why worry? And therefore there is a very nice Subhashit, it says, Chita chinta samayukta bindu matra visheshatah nirjivam dahate chita sajivam dahate chinta. Chita or chinta, samayukta, ek saman hai. केवल कितना अंतर है, बिंदु मात्र विशेषतः, चिता में बिंदु नहीं है और चिंता में बिंदु है, केवल इतना अंतर है क्या? उससे बहुत बड़ा अंतर है. निर्जीवम दहते चिता, निर्जीव व्यक्ति को चिता जलाती है, जिसका जीव चला गया है, गत प्राण, मृत व्यक्ति. बट सजीवम दहते चिंता, वी ऑल लिविंग बींग्स वी कीप डूइंग चिंता. And that burns us always. Therefore, when we are faced with situations in our life, we can either react to the situation or we can respond to the situation. What is the difference between the two? Hamare saab ji, unka example lo, jo office se aaye the, daant khaye the, gire the, wallet chori ho gaya tha. He didn't react to the situation. He could have. Reaction is like soda bottle. Paristhiti ke dwara jab hum hilaye jate hai, to kya aata hai bahar? Something comes up, vispotak. That is how you react. What is response? You respond to a situation. You take a water bottle and shake. Same kind of shaking pressure you apply and you open the bottle, water will be peaceful, right? So no matter what kind of situations come in our life, how we deal with the situations, whether we react or we respond, will determine whether the situation is going to create stress in our life or not. A controlled mind can only respond to the situation, but an uncontrolled mind, it reacts to the situation. Like the situation is same, but when, because reaction or response comes from our mental state, if the mind is controlled, then only you can be calm and peaceful. So therefore we need to have a proper control over our mind. And why it is very important, a small video clip to illustrate this point.
Krishnasya karmasu yukta svapna bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha.
So football controls everything in the game of football, and therefore it is meticulously designed. You might have seen 600 different countries and the people are involved, and so many tests are done on the football. Why we runs the show? Similarly, mind runs the show in our life, right? Do you agree? Therefore, it's being said, mind can create heaven out of hell and hell out of heaven. Any situation can turn topsy-turvy, upside down, and therefore, we need to have a proper control over our mind. And therefore, how do we do that? I take a separate seminar on Panchakosh Vikas of a person. We have five levels of existence: Annamay, Manomay, Pranamay, Vijnanamay and Anandamay. So these are five levels of our existence. So mana, mind, where is mind located in our body? So mind is located, where is mind located in our body? It's in heart, it's in brain, or where it is? It's like asking the question, where is blood in our body? Now you got the answer. So this manomay, because of it stays in the prana, it stays in the prana of our body, and when we do pranayama, have you? You must be knowing about this pranayama exercises, deep breathing exercises. So when we do Surya Namaskar, when you do pranayama, then mind becomes peaceful and we can easily control the mind. We can respond to the situation when the mind is controlled, otherwise we will just react to the situations. Controlling the mind by meditation and chanting, as someone rightly said at the beginning of the session as well, meditation is a scientific process, dear friends, as it's being proved that our brain emits certain kinds of waves of different frequencies. There is called as alpha, beta, gamma, delta and theta, five types of waves our brain emits. When we do meditation, when we practice meditation, then what happens? Our mind emits, or our brain emits alpha rays, which is very conducive for the brain health. And therefore it's being observed that when we do meditation, then these alpha rays are emitted and we feel peace in our life. As was shown in the video, this shloka from Bhagavad Gita 6 chapter 17 verse, yukta har viharasya yukta cheshtasya karmasu yukta swapnava bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha. Regulate your eating, sleeping, recreation and work. We need to regulate our life for exercising mind control. Regulate your eating, eat to live and not just live for the purpose of eating. Eat sattvic food, the food in the mode of goodness, and avoid junk food. Regulate your eating. You should eat proper quantity, not too much, not too little. These are all from the Bhagavad Gita, my dear friends. Bhagavad Gita talks to such a level as well, how to control the mind through these regulated activities. It talks also about our sleeping. Not too much, you will become lazy. If you sleep too less, you become crazy. And therefore, Mahatma Gandhi has rightly said, early to bed, early to rise, make man healthy, wealthy and wise. The next sutra which we are going to see, lifestyle management tip. Are you all with me?
Yes.
Yes. Living one's own life. What does it mean? Living one's own life. Very nicely, Oscar Wilde, a British philosopher, has said, there are moments when one has to choose between living one's own life fully, entirely, completely, or dragging out some false, shallow, degrading existence that the world in its hypocrisy demands. Looking at ourselves from the mirror of others, from the perception of others, log kya kahenge? Someone has sent me a message. Aaj ka sabse bada rog kya kahenge log? Something like that. So we want to fit ourselves into the image of the society, what society has made it as standard, and wants to shape our image in that particular image, what is being received by the society. And therefore life today is decided by likes. And you might be, I don't know whether you know or not, there are different applications like Liker, which you can install to increase the likes through the account of others, so that you feel I got more likes in my Facebook post. So there are applications for that. So this is actually a diseased condition, wanting to get liked by others and living a life of copy and paste. एक बार एक पिताजी लड़के को बोलते हैं, अरे देख वो ज्योति की तरह हमारे बगल में रहती है, तुम्हारे क्लास में पढ़ती है, फर्स्ट आई है क्लास में, देख देख उसकी ओर. बोलते देख देख के ही फेल हुआ हूं. द पॉइंट इज व्हाट सोसाइटी परसीव्स यू वांट टू जस्ट कॉपी एंड पेस्ट इन अवर लाइफ. इन दैट वी हैव फॉरगॉटन टू लिव अवर ओन लाइफ ट्रू टू अवर ओन नेचर. What am I? What am I supposed to do? And therefore people just copy. Here you see who is being copied and who are copying. Therefore, a very nice quote by Albert Einstein, he says, everybody is a genius, but if you judge a fish by its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that it is stupid under stress. If you ask a monkey to swim, it will go in depression and frustration. If you ask an elephant to climb a tree, it will start considering itself as a failure, right? But they have their own unique strengths. Fish can swim properly, monkey can jump properly, elephant can lift a weight properly. They have their unique strengths. They need to focus on their unique strengths, and Krishna calls this in Bhagavad Gita as one's own swadharma. श्रेयान स्वधर्मो विगुण परधर्मात् स्वनिष्ठितात् स्वधर्मे निधनम श्रेय परधर्मो भयाव. He says that it's better to die following one's own swadharma than copying someone else's dharma and acting based on that. So there is no need to copy someone else's life, no need to compare and go into frustration and depression, but focus on your own inner latent hidden talents which God has given us. And therefore ostrich, it doesn't have developed wings, it can't fly, but it has long legs, therefore it can run fast. So it focuses on the ability given by God. Cuckoo, black in color, not very attractive, but the sound is so sweet, it focuses on the sweet sound gifted by God. Bats, they can't see during daytime, but their sense of hearing is so powerful that they just focus on their sense of hearing, and they are called as accident free species. They don't see at all during the daytime, but they never had hit on collision in their life. Why? Because of strong hearing sensation. Ultrasound, they, you might be knowing how they function. We don't have time to discuss that. But they focus on their inner abilities and talents. Similarly, we need to find out our own inner talents and abilities and live our own life which is true to our own nature and not just copy someone else's life. So here we end our lifestyle management tips, and the point is that we can't get rid of stress in life. Again, coming back to that, so therefore what we can do is we can give purpose to the stress which is already there in our life. De-stress with a purpose. So when we give some proper purpose to the stress which we are undergoing in our life, then life will be meaningful, worthy of living, and we will be happy. Like, just to give an example of a mother having a small baby, recently given birth to a small baby. The mother is always in stress. Do you agree? Those who have the motherly experience can say that the baby might get up at any time in the night, mother don't get to sleep properly at proper timings, mother don't even get to eat properly at particular timings, stressful living, but there is joy in living, right? They are happy about it, they love doing it. Why? Because there is purpose associated with it. So when we add purpose to life, then life becomes meaningful. And therefore said, you become like an eagle. When you become like an eagle, you fly at the top, and the small, small things, petty things, little things in your life, like a crow. Crow can't reach to the level of the eagle, but small levels you immediately surpass, bypass, and go through. And not only go through, but grow through these events in your life. And therefore it is said, the purpose of life is the life full of purpose. There is a very great scientist, Dr. David Bennett, is the director of memory and aging unit at Rush Medical College from Chicago. He has conducted this research and he says, people who have meaning and purpose in their life have lower risk of Alzheimer's disease and diseases related to stress is there actually, stress and anxiety. So your stress and anxiety level goes down when you have a proper purpose in your life. Further in his study he says, purpose in life is linked to many positive health outcomes including better mental health, less depression, happiness, satisfaction, personal growth, self-acceptance, better sleep and longevity of life. So when we have a positive purpose in your life, a purpose not only of selfish agenda, but a purpose of doing something great for the sake of others as well. Like mother, when she lives for the purpose of growing this baby, taking care of the baby, a purpose higher than the selfish agenda, then only there can be some joy in life. What is this? Ice cream. Yeah, simple. It's an ice cream. Why I'm showing you this? By the way, it's not there in the menu card today. There is a mentality associated with ice cream, and the mentality is that enjoy it before it melts away. Khalo, pigalne se pehle khalo. And there is another item which also melts, which is candle. But this mentality is enlighten others before you melt. Dusron ko prakash dete hue candle melts. Now the question is, you are a member of which club? The ice cream club, enjoy before it ends, or the candle club, enlighten others through our life and leave a legacy behind before it melts. What kind of membership which you want to pursue? Is this man looking beautiful? Beautiful? Not so as per our standards, standard definition. I'll tell you something about this man. You want to hear? Not very beautiful, but still. His name is Mr. Kalyan Sundaram. He's from South Indian family. During his 35 years long service as a librarian, he willingly donated entire salary every month for the betterment of orphaned kids. Pura salary, 100%. Kiske liye? Orphanages. Just to take care of kids. Entire 35 years of service as a librarian. He retired from there. During Indo-China war, he donated his gold chain to the chief minister of Tamil Nadu at that time. During the war, the only asset he had. Even after retirement, he worked as a waiter in a hotel in exchange for 2 meals a day and a meager salary so that he could continue donating to the orphanages. The entire pension he received, he donated to the orphanages. We all were busy in our ice cream mentality club. United States of America, they recognized this person and they awarded him the award which is called as the Man of Millennium Award. Why? Just because of serving others, living for the higher purpose. He received 32 crore rupees amount in his award, and that too he dedicated fully for the cause of orphan age students. Now looks beautiful. Now looks beautiful. And therefore, it's being said, when I is replaced by we, illness becomes wellness. So we have heard so many things today, right? Different concepts, maybe new things, product orientation, process orientation, ice cream club, candle club, this, that, time management, 4 L's, right? What do I gain out of this? How much can I apply in my life? So in the conclusion, I'd like to say, there is a concept called as aggregation of marginal gains. Small, small things done over a longer duration of time. What is 1 multiplied by 1? It's 1. 1 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 1? Still 1. 1 to the power 365? Still 1, right? 1 to the power 365 is also equal to 1. 1.01 to the power 365. Any guess? 0.01 increase. That's all. This is homework for you. You calculate on a scientific calculator. I am giving you the answer. You have to just clarify whether it's correct or not. But I have calculated. It's 37.78, a 0.01 increase. 365 signifies the number of days in a year. If over a particular period of time, you develop a positive habit, maybe very small in quantity, and start following that, at the end, the result is going to be very large. And on the contrary, a small negative change in life, 0.99 to the power 365, when you calculate this, it comes to 0.03. So such a drastic change in the result we are getting just because of the small change. And I hope and pray that whatever we have learned today, you apply at least a small percentage in your life and make your life stress free. Thank you all very much. Hare Krishna.